Today, we're going to be talking about Leave the World Behind, a movie produced by none other than the Obamas themselves. Let's talk about it. Welcome to Red Anecdote. I created this channel with the intent of bringing a biblical Christian perspective onto worldly things. And without any further ado, let's jump into it. I'd like to start off by playing you guys the trailer of the movie. I'm sure many of you guys have heard of this movie. It was a movie that, it was a buzz when it came out. It was a Netflix original. It was produced by the Obamas. And according to the stat, they had a major role in writing the script. And Obama actually released a statement about it. And he said that it was so close to what would really happen in reality that it's scary. It had Julia Roberts, which played the mother and a wife in the movie. And her statement was, it made her reevaluate things because she realized that the world is so fragile. And let's jump into it.
I went online this morning and I rented us a beautiful house out by the beach. I figured if I made the reservation and packed our bags, it would eliminate most of the reasons to say no.
Oh, this is nice. Kids look so happy.
The Wi-Fi isn't working. Get a pad.
I like to say a few things about this, so they made the guy such a cuck in this movie. He doesn't do anything. All he does is nods his head, agrees with her, and looks lost and confused the whole time. They made her such a brave and strong and empowered woman. And she makes all the decisions. And she's so sharp. And she can see things happening before they happen. And the guy is just lost the whole time.
I'm so sorry to bother you, and this is our house.
This is your house?
Of course, they also had to throw it in there, some racism, right? Against white people not believing that black people can actually own something like this. And throughout the movie, there's a lot more that happens. And I'm not sure how many of you saw the movie, but spoiler. They keep constantly fighting because the girl, his daughter, the black girl, she keeps telling her dad the whole time that they cannot trust black people or white people. They cannot trust white people. It's like, you and mom would agree with me that we cannot trust these people. And we have to look out for ourselves. And later on in the movie, they actually end up like realizing that they can trust each other and work with each other. But throughout the whole movie, it's like since she gets there, she's just mean the whole time and just condescending and arrogantly just being bluntly racist towards them, saying they can't trust them. And she's like mad that they're there. And she's like, we got to get rid of them. It's insane. But like, let's keep watching.
We were driving back to the city. Then something happened.
You want to stay here, but we're staying here.
We need to get them out of here.
I need to think everything's going to be okay.
Everything is going to be okay, isn't it?
We are seeing ongoing cyber attacks across the country.
Something is happening, and I don't trust them.
Everything I know, I have told you.
I don't believe you.
I would do anything to protect my family. What you do is your business.
Get in the car right now!
Yeah, this scene is just like, he's just sitting there looking at the sky and nothing, and she just realizes, like, the cars are just driving themselves, and we got to do something. She starts screaming at the guy, like, get in the car, because he's just sitting there. The car's coming, but he wants to ask for help. So the movie's pretty much about a cyber attack that takes place and takes down communications, cell phones, TV, anything. Takes out everything. Not only that, but plane starts falling from the sky and ships crashing into the beach. But the story of the movie, so the main thing is, like, there's a plan for it, right? It's a 3-stage maneuver, which is to deaf, dumb, and paralyze the people. The second stage is to synchronize chaos, no certain enemy. And then the third stage of the movie, which they say it would just develop all on itself, right? It would happen all on its own. Which is the coup d'etat, right? And there's so many predictive programming in this movie. It's insane. Like, I'll play you guys a video in a little bit about that. That shows you some of them, but it's insane how much, like, predictive programming there is in this movie, and how much they wanted this movie to, how they created this movie just to implement things in your mind. And interesting enough, did the Obamas predict cyber attacks? Because the week the movie came out, we had a cyber attack. We had a cyber attack on the power, the water grid, oil pipelines, and Rumble was also attacked. Insane. The same week the movie came out, all this happened. So now, I don't know if you believe in coincidences, but I don't. I believe things are always made with an intent. They're always made with a reason. We've had movies that predicted the pandemic, COVID. There was that movie, Contagion. I think it came out in 2011. There was also a book that was written, I think sometime, I think it was like 2013. And from that book, there was a series on Netflix that also predicted everything that happened during the pandemic and during COVID. And it came out, I think it came out like 2018, the series. It was on Netflix. I can't remember the name. Not only that, but the big one that happened in 2001, I won't say it because I don't want them to take this down. But the X-Files had a spinoff show that was called The Lone Gunman. And it predicted that a plane would hit some buildings. But in the show, it was piloted by a drone. It was a drone, but it was predicted. That same building, it was predicted all on that show. So I honestly believe that they tell us these things, that we're told these things, and they tell us ahead of time. They believe, and when I say they, I think this is all, it's all based on a religion, right? A Luciferian religion, a satanic religion that believes that they believe in karmic retribution. They have to tell you what they're doing, so they're not responsible for it. So they're not to blame for it, because they told you what they're doing. It takes their guilt away. It takes their culpability away. And these things are called predictive programming for a reason. They put these things in our faces. They teach us these things. They tell us these things so we can learn how to think. So we don't learn how to think for ourselves. So we think how they want us to think. They're constantly telling us what they're doing through movies, TV, music. Klaus Schwab predicted, he's been predicting that there's going to be a cyber attack on America, and internet's going to go out, and TV's going to go out, and cell phones are going to go out. So he's been telling us that. Now, the Obamas put their names behind this movie, which is, to me, it's a very, like he said that it's so close to what's going to happen, that so close to what would happen, that it's scary. So They're telling us. They're constantly telling us. They tell us through movies. They tell us through music. Do you honestly think that the Simpsons are seeing the future? They're predicting the future? It's impossible. No one can predict the future. But they know what's going to happen because it's been a part of a plan for a very long time. They've been planning this stuff for a very long time. And it's not today. It's not 10 years from 10 years ago. It's from hundreds and hundreds of years ago. These things come from so long ago. It's insane. Now, here's another clip of what I wanted to play for you guys. It's about all the conspiracy theories that evolves around this movie and all the subliminal messages and hidden messages in this movie. It's not all of them, but it's just a few, just so you guys can have an idea. Found it on TikTok, by the way.
From the movie Leave the World Behind, these are the items.
See, people say it says, I am Bao right here. It says, I in her name and am. That was one of the big ones. This one is another one. Predictive programming. Obey NASA. That's a big one. If you guys are into conspiracy theories, there's a lot to unpack here. And, you know, obey NASA, believe the science, all that stuff. Say NASA is the symbol. NASA is the tongue of a snake. Pause that if you guys want to read. I don't know if you can see that.
The QR code links to a website.
Oh yeah, there was a QR code. Amusement park. Mark Zuckerberg is building a Hawaii compound with plans to for an escape hatch, blind doors, and an underground bunker. I know about that. I did not see that in the movie.
His wife, her head moves and follow him as he runs.
But yeah, I'll leave you guys with this. We a lot of times, like, we don't know what really happens, what the big plan is for everything. And there's always a plan. If you think things just happen coincidentally, you're naive. You're just blind to what really goes on in the world. And men, we like to think we're in control of things, right? Especially, like, if you're... like, not at our level, but the people above, the people that are in control, they always like to think that they're in control and that they know everything that's going to happen and they have everything planned out. But God's plans, everything only happens. The Bible says that everything only happens if God allows it to happen. It says that not a leaf falls from a tree if it's not God's will. Not a hair from our head falls from our head if it's not God's plan. And with that, I'll leave you guys with this verse here. In Jeremiah 29:11, it says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans of prosper, plans to prosper you and not harm you, plans to give you hope in the future." So no matter what people's plans are, no matter who the people in charge are and what they're planning, God's plan always prevails. The Bible says that everything happens so that the world of God can be fulfilled. So don't let these things discourage you, scare you. Always be attentive. James 6:1 says, do not let yourself be deceived. Always be attentive. Always watch. Always try to figure out what they're doing and what they're hiding from you, what they're not trying to show you, what they're not trying to tell you. keep your ears and eyes open. I'll leave you guys with that. If you guys like this type of content, make sure you like and follow for more. We'll see you on the next one. Peace.